Mark is getting a tattoo from Jason at Deep Root Seattle. After traveling across the state from Spokane, Mark has thought long and hard about his decision, and he's ready to put himself under the needle. Why would he be willing to endure this kind of pain, though?
Welcome to my life, tattoo. I'm a man now, thanks to you.
To find out why people get tattoos, let's hear from graduate students Michelle Morado and Jeffrey Palmer at the University of Washington.
Well, like any behavior, I think it's really difficult to say that there is only one explanation for it. I think there's at least a couple. Some people will get tattoos to make themselves stand out in a crowd. Some people get tattoos in order to make themselves fit in. Some people will get tattoos in order to express themselves or to commemorate an event. So there's lots of different reasons. Or sometimes people also get tattoos because of social pressure. Sometimes people like to go to the tattoo parlor together to commemorate an event that they all shared, like in Starship Troopers.
There's a long history of artwork that goes along with it, traditions from different areas of the world that are passed on. So it's a picture on yourself. It's this kind of moving artwork that you get to carry with you. And I think it's also influenced by your community that you're in as well.
If you go back in time, tattoos were only worn by a minority of people. But these days, we think that about 15 to 16% of adults have tattoos. As far as I'm concerned, the most interesting thing is this movement from tattoos being a fringe activity to tattoos being a mainstream activity. And it's interesting to think about some of the ways that this might have happened. Some people really point towards celebrities and their power in changing the minds of the population. So, you know, you can think about all your favorite movie stars. Angelina Jolie has tattoos. Dennis Rodman had a ton of tattoos. You know, plenty of people have tats. I don't think Obama has tats. Yeah, I don't know, but if he did, would he tell you? I mean, you don't know. But Barbie has a tat now. There was a 2009 Barbie came out with a tat. I think they call her Tattooed Barbie. It sells out. You know, it's one of their hottest Barbies. It just flies off the shelves. You know, so they're totally mainstream these days. And I think that's a fascinating thing to think about, although it might be difficult to explain exactly how it's happened.
Now that we've learned why people get tattoos, let's check back with Jason at Deep Roots to hear about what it's like to be an artist in the business, and also what it's like having a tattoo.
I think it used to be a lot more an act of rebellion than it is today. Today it's definitely more about, obviously, belonging. It's definitely really big among, you know, people at about 20 years old. I think myself it's sort of a rite of passage. Our culture in general doesn't have any sort of rites of passage for adulthood. And so I think people make their own. So I think, you know, not necessarily just being involved in a specific group of people. I think it's, you know, sort of a decision they make themselves that is, you know, just about being an adult, I guess.
Not surprisingly, tattoos can be very controversial. Let's get out on the streets and hear some opinions from people in the neighborhood.
Some people do it for validation, some people do it to like appear more tough, other people do it as simply just a form of self-expression and conveying art.
I don't know, some people, I think they get tattoos like to be down or whatever and be like, look at my full sleeves or whatever, yo, I'm like from the streets or whatever, and so I think it like helps them gain some sort of street credibility or something like that within whatever scene they're in.
But I think back in the old days, it was only, I thought it was on like a certain type of person that would wear a tattoo. So I think they become more mainstream and more acceptable. I see it almost as graffiti. You know, like I don't like seeing a building with a lot of graffiti on it, so I like everything clean. So that's how I kind of view it, and that's why I don't have any.
Now tattoos are becoming more and more a part of acceptable pop culture, like exceptionally bad music, you know, or worse, Lady Gaga. But that's only my opinion.
Just about everybody has a tattoo nowadays, so
that's not
you
true,
know, I think it's fine, it's okay. You know, it's a new era.
Well, I think it's a bad idea because it's not really healthy for your skin. To put a massive amount of ink on your skin can't be good for it. And I think that once you have a tattoo, for the most part, you're really stuck with it.
But what is it actually like having a tattoo? Let's hear from Zach.
Yeah, I believe tattoos are not a bad thing. There's to me, there's no negative connotation. I mean, people get tattoos to express themselves. People paint paintings to express themselves, and you don't call Picasso an evil man. In the past, tattoos have been used to distinguish people who have done deviant acts or are part of subcultures that are considered. In the modern culture, the majority of us, we're not affiliated with those people. Tattoos to us are just expression. I don't think, no matter how old I get, I will always say that that's what I got. And if it's faded and wrinkly, whatever, it doesn't hurt me. I don't have to look at it. You have to look at it. So get used to it. You want something here? Pick something different. Take that garbage to say elsewhere.
To our music at night, thus spawned the title of this program. The word maraud means to loot. In this case, we maraud for ears.